गुड मॉर्निंग
मॉर्निंग मैम. गुड मॉर्निंग मैम.
सरप्राइजेस यस्टरडे राइट इवनिंग आल्सो यू गॉट अनदर सरप्राइज टू साइकोलॉजी पीरियड्स आई हैव नथिंग टू डू विद दैट आई डिडंट टेल एनीथिंग द ऑर्डर हैज कम फ्रॉम देयर नॉट मी ओके एनीवेज वील बी लर्निंग अबाउट सेलेक्टिव अटेंशन टुडे एंड आई विल I'll take only a small portion. We'll divide it in the among the two bits and complete the selective attention. Okay. Now I'll share the screen. We'll see a video now. We'll see the video first and then come back. Do as instructed in the test. Okay. Can you see the screen now? Yes, everyone. Please be careful while you count. Yes, how many passes did you count? How many passes did you count?
9. 9.
Who wrote 9? I didn't hear.
Ekna.
Ashish, how many did you count?
8. 8. 8. Yes, how many did you count, Meghna?
9. 9.
Amal?
And 8. 8.
Ashish?
8. 8.
Sana?
White, sir, 2.
White.
3. 10. 3. 3.
I told the passes, the number of passes. She mistook. Okay, Aishwarya?
7.
7. Okay, Raina?
7, ma'am.
Huh?
7.
7. Okay, Grishma? Grishma has lost the connection. Elvina? Elvina, are you there? Video,
ma'am, to count all the people.
No, to count the number of passes the people with white jersey had. Did you see? No, joined late.
Yes, ma'am.
We have 7, 8, 9, 10. Any other answers? No, right? That's all. Did you all see the suicide man? How many of you saw? Aishwarya saw, Reina saw, Amal, Meghna, and Ashish. You didn't see?
Suicide Squad?
Huh? What, Ashish? What did you tell?
I don't understand.
You did not understand. Did you see a man with the rope around his neck?
No.
No. Okay, fine. I'll show the video, the rest of the video on screen. See, the rewind. He was there. He came in between and he left. It happened. And the number of passes were 12, I think. 12, I guess. See, he is coming. He stood in the middle and he left. Some of you didn't see him. And correct answer is 12. Okay. Yes, that's enough. Just a minute. Yeah. So the fact that some of you didn't notice him, that is because of selective attention. You chose to see the number of passes. You wanted to attend to the number of passes. Sana, did you see that man? Suicide man? Okay. Yeah. Similarly, we have one more test similar to this. There is a giant bear coming in between. But most of the people don't notice the bear. The bear is very big, black in color. Others are wearing white jersey, but still they fail to notice. Okay. So that's about the selective attention. This is a basic or a classic test for selective attention. You can show it to your cousins or relatives and try it out. Okay. Okay. So Ashish, Amal, Meghna, and Sana, you could only see the, you were attending to the passes, the number of passes by the people with white jersey. And that's why you couldn't notice the suicide man. And Aishwarya and Reina, somehow your attention was divided into the other suicide man. Okay. That's about the test. Now we'll move on to the topic for today. We already learned what selective attention is. Yes or no? Did we study what selective attention is?
Yes.
What are selective attention?
We tend to attend to only one stimulus.
Some stimuli. Some of the rest. That is selective attention. So there are two basic factors that affect the selective attention. And they are generally called external factors and internal factors. Note down external factors as well as internal factors. And external factors means factors outside the person, that is, characteristics of the stimuli. External factors refers to characteristics of stimuli. Copy down that lecture note of yours. External factors means characteristics of the stimuli. Now, internal factors means characteristics of individuals, internal, that is internal to the individual. That means it is some personal characteristics of the person. Okay. So internal factors means characteristics of the individual. Again, external factors means the characteristics of the stimuli. The internal means characteristics of the individual. Now, in each section, we have different characteristics. We'll see what they are in separate. First, we'll start with internal factors. Internal factors, we again have subdivision. They're divided into motivational factors and cognitive factors. Write down motivational and cognitive factors. Motivational factors and cognitive factors. Okay. Amal, can you read from the textbook? Motivational factors, page 94. Last paragraph. Sana, make sure you copy down that to your lecture notes, okay? Sana. Because you have to file that along with the other assignments and all. You'll have to file your lecture notes, that's what I'm telling. Okay, Amal. Yes, you can read.
I can.
Factors.
Motivation factors and cognitive factors.
Hmm.
Motivational factors are related to our biological or social needs.
Okay, that's enough.
Definition.
Motivational factors relate to our biological or social needs. Biological or social needs. So imagine you're very hungry. You are attending your maths class. You're very hungry at that time. You're attending your maths class. And if you see some ads in your phone, some might be of Myntra, the of the dress, of the apparel. Some might be of food items. Which will you notice first? Which will you notice first? Which is more probable to catch your attention? Yes?
Food.
Food, of course, because you are very hungry and you're in need of food. So obviously you will, or most probably you will attend to the food item. That is what you mean by the motivational factor. It depends on your motivation or your need, your biological need. Biological need, for example, hunger, or your social need. You might be looking for your friend. You might be alone and then you might notice your friend. That is a social need for you. You want to talk to someone. You were alone earlier, so you want to talk to someone. So that is again a motivational factor. So you'll attend to your friend. You'll give more attention to your friend among a crowd. Yes, that is motivational factor. Now we have cognitive factors. Cognitive factors include, who will read? Meghna, you can read. Cognitive factors include?
Cognitive factors include factors like interest, attitude, and preparatory test.
Preparatory set. Yes, you can note down that also. Cognitive factors include interest, attitude, and preparatory set. Interest, of course, you might know. You only attend to something that grabs your interest, or something that you are very interested in tends to grab your attention more. Like if I'm showing a psychology test on one screen and some BTS video on the other screen, which will you look or which will you attend to? Tell me, which will you attend to? Girls.
BTS video.
Of course, obviously the BTS video. And that is because you're interested in it. Well, Ashish, he is very interested in psychology. He doesn't know what BTS is, so obviously he will look only at the psychology video, isn't it, Ashish? Yes.
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Fine. I hope so. Okay. So cognitive factors. The first one is interest. Then we have attitude. If we have a positive attitude towards something, then we tend to be attracted towards it. We tend to notice it fast. Just like the same example, it's more or less the same. If we have a positive attitude towards something, those items tend to grab our attention faster than the ones which we don't have a good attitude about. Okay. Then the third one is a new term for you, that is preparatory set. Note the spelling, preparatory set. P-R-E-P-A-R-A-T-O-R-Y, preparatory set. Note down preparatory set. And the definition is, preparatory set generates a mental state. Preparatory set generates a mental state to act in a certain way and readiness of the individual and readiness of the individual to respond to one kind of stimuli and not to others. One kind of stimuli and not to others. One kind of stimuli and not to others. Finished? Okay. Did you just read that definition or read that concept once? Just read that. Did you understand anything? Did you understand anything? Somewhat? Whatever you understood, you tell me. And I'll modify on that. Anyone? Aishwarya?
It makes us to act in a specific way to a specific stimuli.
Yes. That's true. That's the same thing. Okay. So preparatory set means it makes up a mental state. And how that mental state will be is we should act in a particular way. That mental state keeps on telling us that we should act in a particular way or respond in this particular way to a particular stimuli. Understood? It prepares us. That is why it is called preparatory set. It prepares us to respond in such a way. I'll give you an example. Imagine that you are playing tennis or badminton with your friend. And the other person is serving. You know what a serve is, right? Yes, the other person is the one who is serving. And then you have a preparatory set there. You are very much attended to how and when this person is going to serve. So you're being prepared or ready to strike back. Understood? That is preparatory set. Similarly, when we play chess, you will calculate all the moves of the other person. And then you will be thinking, if this person moves this coin or this particular pawn or horse or whatever it is, if this person moves this coin, then I am going to move this one. You're already prepared there. Yes, you calculate all the possibilities of the moves and then you stay prepared. You stay attended to it. Yes or no? That is what is called preparatory set. Okay, it's a big name but a simple concept. That's it. Fine. Okay, that's about which factors are we learning now?
Cognitive factors.
Cognitive factors, and that comes under
internal factors.
Internal factors, yes. So internal factors, there are two types of internal factors, motivation and cognition. That is motivational factors and cognitive factors. Clear? Yes? Simple, no? Yes, you just have to memorize those terms. That's it. Then the next one is, which was the next one? Which was the next set of factors?
External
factors. External factors. Actually, we have too many external factors, but for the time being, you learn these five. Note down and then we'll discuss. Size. First one is size. Then we have intensity. Then we have motion. And you have novel stimuli or novelty. We have sudden stimuli. Yes, size, intensity, motion, novelty or novel stimuli, then sudden stimuli. Finished. Okay. First one is size. So imagine that too many ants are crawling on the, or walking on the, or whatever, moving on the floor. Ants, small ants. And then along with them, a big beetle is also moving. Which will you notice, the ant or the beetle?
Beetle,
of course. That is because the things of larger size tend to grab our attention. Okay, and that is an external factor, right? The size of the stimuli. The stimuli here is the ant and the beetle. So the size of the stimuli is an external factor, and the increase in size tend to grab our attention. And give me another example for this from your daily life example. I mean daily life situations. Everybody think of a situation. It's very easy and it's very common also. See, everything that we study in psychology happens in our life. We are just giving names for it. Preparatory set you have experienced in your life, right? And yesterday we learned about the sustained attention. You have experienced that in your life. Selective attention you have experienced, but you didn't know the names. That's all. You're just trying to name them. That's all. Yes. Size, any example? Amal, I think you have an example. Do you? No. No. Think. Give me an example. Let it be wrong. It's okay.
In textbook.
Yes. Yeah, we lost the net connection in between. You can give the example. Alphabetic order, Aishwarya.
In textbook, we see small words, but in between, when we see bolded letters, we notice that.
Ah, yes, yes, true. Then, Meghna.
When we see the bag beside the pouch, we notice the bag first.
Ah, fine. Any other examples? Yes, no? I'll give you another example. If you see a Toblerone sitting next to a Naringamitai, which will you notice?
Toblerone.
Of course. Any Toblerone fans? Me too. Okay, then the next one is intensity. So size is clear, right? That point is clear. Intensity. Intensity, when we learn brightness, we learned intensity. Intensity of light. So the brighter things tend. Somebody else is coming. Is it time? Is it time to leave? 12:15, no? Ah, okay. So the brighter things, or the things with bright stimuli with brighter intensity, or with more amount of brightness, tend to grab our attention than the dull ones, the ones with lower intensity. Okay, another example can be when you go for a wedding. In olden days and all, most of the brides used to wear which color? Probably in Hindu weddings, which color do you see? Sari color?
Red.
Red? Or shades of red, most probably. Now they choose pastel colors and all, new generation, yes, of course. But then the highlight would be that particular color. Yes or no? So even if you look from the entrance, or even if you look from away from the entrance, you can see the bride's costume in a very prominent way. You tend to attend, or you the bride grabs your attention. Yes or no? That is because that color has a high intensity. That is very bright compared to the rest of the. Okay. That is about the intensity. So in intensity, how you have to elaborate it is like this. That is the stimuli with brighter colors, or with high amount of brightness, tend to grab our attention than the ones with lower amount of brightness. Okay. Clear? Raina, any doubt? You look a bit puzzled. Any confusions? Or thinking about the bright still? Okay, fine. Yes, the next one is motion. Motion is something in motion tends to grab our attention than the things that are static. That is, that don't move. For example, when you are coming out of a shopping mall, you see so many cars and bikes parked there. But then one super bike goes in front of you in high speed. Which one will you notice? Of course, the super bike. Yes or no? Yes. Okay, that's the example for motion. The things in motion tend to grab our attention than the ones which are not in movement. That is, in common words, moving objects grab our attention than the non-moving ones. Then, clear, no? Size, intensity, and motion. Clear? Yes. The next point is novelty. Novelty means anything new. Novelty. Novel stimuli or novelty. Again, anything new tends to grab your attention than the old ones, than the ones which you have already seen or which you have already heard. If on the first day of class, if a new student is coming to your class. Then the new student grabs a lot of attention, right? Any new students? Elvina is new, I know. Anybody else? Ashish, are you new?
Yes. Ashish,
Elvina. Only two new students? Only two new students?
No, ma'am, me.
Sana also? Okay, three new students, okay. Yeah, if you were in the class, then we had the usual schooling, not the online schooling. Yeah, the new students tend to grab more attention. Yes or no? Yes? You see that commonly, right? Yeah. So that's about novelty. Novelty means the new stimuli. The new stimuli tends to grab our attention than the old ones or the ones that you have already seen or heard of. Now the last one is sudden stimuli. Sudden stimuli means anything that comes at a sudden, grabs your attention. That is when I'm taking class and somebody, somebody suddenly joined our class. Then you would not look at me, but you look at them, right? Yes or no? Yes or no? Yes. Mm-hmm. Unmute and tell. I don't have the capability to overhear if you are muted. Ashish, I'm telling you. He's sitting there and happily telling yes. But I can't hear you. I have to read your lips, right? Okay, now are the points clear? Size, intensity, motion, novelty, sudden stimuli? Yes? Yes or no, again?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay. Aishwarya again left and joined. Yes, any doubt? Anybody else in all these points? No, ma'am, at least.
No,
I'll assign somebody to tell me yes, ma'am, or no, ma'am, each day. Today it is Meghna. You have to tell me yes, ma'am, no, ma'am, or whatever it is. Yes, so I'll ask Raina, which are the factors influencing selective attention? Main factors?
External and internal.
External and internal. External factors refers to what, Amal? Characteristics of
stimuli
and internal factors, characteristics of
my individual or
the person. Very good. Then next is what are the external factors? Ashish, don't look, we just discussed it. Now tell me which one you remember.
Size, color, brightness.
Keep look at me and tell me the answer.
Color.
Did we discuss color? Oh, that was intensity.
Okay. Intensity.
Size, intensity.
Motion. Sudden stimuli.
Stimuli, one more. Something related to new. Novel stimuli, okay? Yes, and the external factors, who will say? Sana?
Motivational.
I asked the external factors. Did you notice? No attention at all. Okay. Yeah, internal factors.
Motivational.
And
cognitive.
Okay, very good. Which are the motivational factors, Raina? Or what are the motivational factors that satisfy our two types of needs?
Preset.
No. Motivational factors and cognitive factors. There are two categories. Motivational factors are the factors that tend to satisfy our two types of needs. Which are the two types of needs, Aishwarya?
Needs. Huh? Immediate.
No. I gave the definition for motivational. Amal read it out also. Biological and social needs. Okay, motivational satisfies the biological and social needs. For example, hunger. No. Then we have the other factors, which are cognitive factors, including interest, attitude, and preparatory set. Okay, don't confuse. Go home, study it today itself. Okay, I'll ask it tomorrow. We have one more class, so see you then. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am.